All right, I unlocked his phone, and it looks like Swayzak was in regular contact with someone, but the number appears to run on a voice over IP service.
Wait, so it can't be traced?
Not easily. If we can keep the caller on the line long enough, I can backtrace the signal through the anonymizing service to get the owner's IP address and location.
Care to do the honors? She's gonna hang up.
I've already traced the call through 5 anonymous service.
Swayzak, are you there?
How many more are there?
I don't know. I just need more time.
Swayzak?
Hey, she's not gonna be out much longer.
Swayzak?
Well, whoever we just spoke to, that should put her on notice.
I have an idea. We can run voice print analysis on the recording. If there are any voice samples in any of the databases, we should get a hit.
Where are you? Swayzak.
Where are you?
You gotta be kidding me.
Well, either we were just talking to a ghost or Nadine Amherst is still very much alive.
So she faked her own death. Why would she do that?
Because she wanted us to think that she was the victim, when actually all along she was behind this whole thing.
Exactly. The only question now is why.